So everything we're going to see today is going to be compared to the second house?
Yes.
Yes, it will be.
But it's the mystery property.
Yeah.
So, Judy, you know the drill. What do you think we're going to show you now?
Well, probably what we've said all along, dark and pokey.
Yeah, I mean, that's you especially, as well, isn't it, Goose? I mean, you want big, light, airy rooms.
I love light, airy rooms, yes.
Right, OK. We're a few minutes away from finding out.
Uh-huh. Excellent.
So, a quick game of I Spy.
The final stop on Goose and Judy's property tour is in Burgh Hill, which is our closest location to their daughter in Dindor, being just about 20 minutes' drive away. Settled into the valley, Burgh Hill is a highly desirable village that has a good-looking stock of homes. And with anticipation about the mystery house brewing, we're going to relieve at least one half of the party by stopping off at the local golf course, right on the edge of the village.
You may be wondering why on earth I've borrowed a set of these funny-shaped sticks. But after listening to just how passionate you are, Goose, I thought I'd give you your fix and maybe get the chance to blow some cobwebs out and hit a few balls.
Sounds like a good idea, and maybe we could then go to the 19th hole afterwards.
Well, I would say maybe that the loser buys the beers, but by the sounds of it, that's going to be me, isn't it? Let's just hit the ball, yeah?
OK.
Your wife's watching.
Yes.
Your wife who loves you.
OK.
She's watching. Four! I'm only joking. I'll be lucky if mine goes anywhere over the ladies' tee. You know, the safest place to be is probably over there.
Yeah.
Right, so have a quick practice, will I?
Looks all right. Looks all right.
You wait till I miss it.
Whoa.
Well, I am impressed.
Good one.
Well, I think that was a beginner's luck. Now, the main reason I wanted to start off today here is because the mystery house is, well, a decent golf drive away from here.
Right, OK.
The local village is just over that hill.
OK.
And this is actually one of two golf courses to choose from.
Excellent news.
OK, let's put these funny sticks away and go house hunting.
Yeah, great, brilliant. Thank you.
So, with some peace of mind about the essential local facilities at hand, it's time to unveil the mystery house, which is just a five-minute walk away.
So, here we are.
It's really sweet. Lovely. Quintessential cottage.
Yeah, you see it on a box of chocolates,
yeah,
don't you?
Yeah, chocolate
box. It's a country house if I've ever seen one.
Yeah.
Yeah, lovely.
The second part is what it looks and feels like inside. So let's find out.
OK.
We've chosen this listed part thatch cottage because it's definitely not the light and roomy home our buyers asked for. And it's packed to the rather low rafters with traditional features.
Righty ho, another island for you, Judy.
Oh, another island, yeah. Nice kitchen.
Very nice kitchen.
I like it.
Isn't it? Really nice.
It is really
nice. Yeah, it's lovely.
Well, this kitchen was built back in 2001. Is it your taste? Because it'd be a shame to rip anything out, wouldn't it?
It is. I like the colour.
Good. OK.
I hope there might be another area.
Two reception rooms to have a look at. Which one do you want to have as a dining room, then?
Oh.
Oh, lovely. This is lovely. It's really nice.
Yeah, I like this room.
Dining in here?
Absolutely superb.
What about these ceilings? Are these OK?
These ceilings
fine for me.
They're not bad for me, to be honest with you. Now, just through that doorway, they put a downstairs loo, so your guests don't go traipsing through the rest of your house again.
Good.
All these guests are yours.
All these guests.
Now, a room just for you two. I think you'll love it. Follow me. So, I think this is for you.
This is cosy. That's nice.
A real fire.
Yep.
Can you imagine sitting here on a winter's evening?
Made for it, isn't it?
Yeah, perfect.
Quick look at the master bedroom.
Yep.
All right, follow me.
The stairs are in the corner of the sitting room and go up to the first floor landing where there are three bedrooms and a family bathroom. Two of the bedrooms are similar sized doubles, one of which is presented with a single bed. And the final bedroom is, of course, the master suite.
So there are height restrictions up here to an extent.
Oh, this is nice. I like it. Nice and bright.
Got a bit of storage there.
Well, have a look at that storage. Have a quick peek.
Ha-ha!
Quite sneakily put in there.
Oh, sweet.
It's not massive up here.
No, it's not, but...
No, it's not,
too
I think
pokey.
It would...
It isn't?
Okay. And it's light. And yeah, there it is.
You do have a few views from this bedroom. It obviously overlooks the garden, which I'm really keen on showing you, because, again, very different, but I think there's upsides to it as well.
OK. Right,
let's take a peek.
OK.
So far, the vintage mystery property seems to be successfully dispelling Goose and Judy's fear of dark and dingy cottages. Garden-wise, there's a gravelled patio and a large lawn, as well as some raised beds. But there's also a little something just for Judy.
You mentioned you'd like to, you know, when you do get the chance to retire, maybe taking up your art again.
Yeah.
Those two sheds are actually joined up. They make a lovely little artist studio.
Excellent.
Right, okay.
So, your village location, yet you've got the right-sized garden, your quirky but hopefully the right-sized house.
It is the right-sized house.
What do you think it's worth?
£395.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to go lower.
Why have you got that funny... Why have you got this expression on your face?
Because I think I know what this property costs.
Have you seen it?
I've seen it on the internet.
OK.
And actually, I wanted to come and see it.
Cheating.
Oh, did you?
I did.
Oh, that's good, then.
Yeah.
So if we hadn't have showed you this house, you might want to come and look at it.
I probably would have come and seen it anyway, yeah.
OK. Well, go on, then. How much do you think this place is on the market for, or how much you know it's on the market for?
£365,000.
This is smug Judy, isn't it? Yeah, I've just met smug Judy. Well, yes, you're absolutely quite right. £365,000. For you, then, I mean, you thought it was...
More.
A lot more.
Because of the location. It's an unusual house.
Yeah.
Very unusual house. It's listed. And, yeah, I just thought it was more.
Yeah.
It's really nice property.
You've got to have a look at this house without me in your ear. Have a look at all the rooms you haven't yet seen. Spend some time in the garden. And then we'll find out what you want to do afterwards. All right?
Okay.
Wonderful idea.
So go back into the house and have a look at the other bedrooms, yeah?
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm getting the impression that Goose is quite impulsive, but Judy's playing her cards fairly close to her chest. Maybe it's because she's seen it on the internet before, I'm not sure. But when you look at their shopping list, it's pretty close, isn't it?
Our lowest price option with a guide price of £365,000, the mystery house is a Grade II listed timber-framed and clad cottage. It has a stylish country kitchen breakfast room, two separate reception rooms and three bedrooms, including a master ensuite. Outside, there's a large, well-tended garden, and the property is located smack bang in the centre of the village, right next door to a golf course.
Oh, this is a lovely bright room.
It is.
Fit a double bed in here.
Yeah. There's room for creating some storage as well.
Yep.
As they've done
there. Yeah.
And maybe along this wall as well.
More along this wall too.
Yeah.
I really love the house. I thought that it's really, really pretty. It's a real chocolate box house and right in the middle of a village, which is perfect. And obviously not far from the golf club, which, so the whole thing was really, I was thrilled.
I think this one suits us by far the most, and I now place this as my favourite house.
I must say, even on a slightly chilly day today, you get the sense of what it must be like here in the summer on this patio, don't you? So I think we need a bit of thinking time, then maybe we'll catch up for a chat, yeah?
Yeah.
Good. Okay.